Hey, you want to laugh at some AI models? Stick around. Welcome to Tales from the Jar Side. Welcome. My name's Ken Cousin. On the Tales from the Jar Side channel, we generally talk about AI and Java, among other topics, but we're more focused on why things work and how to use them productively, rather than just announcing the latest and greatest fad. But let's have some fun. Let me set up the problem we're about to ask the models. I plan to run a single test on 13 different models that are all installed to run locally on my machine. Here is the question I'm going to ask it. What is the sum of the lengths of the words in the sentence, "The quick brown fox jumped over the lazy dog"? That's it. Just find the lengths of the words, add them up. That's all I want to see. I actually wrote in a little bit of code here to make sure I get the right answer out of that, just so I don't put in the wrong number like I did when I first ran the test. This is a JUnit 5 parameterized test. The beauty of this is it allows me to run the same test over and over again with different inputs. And my test here is going to compute that question with different model names. And this value source shows I'm using models ranging from orca-mini to llama 2 to Phi to neural chat, all the ones you can see here. These are all installed through the Olama system on my local machine, which is an M1 Mac with 64 gigs of RAM. So these are small to medium sized models. There's nothing huge, but they're decent and they do run relatively effectively on my local machine. The LangChain for J system, which is what I'm using, allows me to set up to run the models on my local machine on port 11434. And then I'm just calling the generate method, get back an answer and compare it to see if that answer inside the string contains the right number, the length there. That's everything. Now to do this for real, you don't need Java, you don't need Olama, you don't need LangChain for J. It's just convenient for me to make this whole thing automated and I could click a button and get all the tests out after one run. Okay. Good. Wish me luck. Have fun. Okay, I realized after I ran this that I had updated the sentence. The original sentence was "the quick brown fox jumps over the lazy dog." And while I'd updated that to run it, I'd forgotten to update the answer. And the answer should be 36. There are 36 letters if you sum the lengths of all of those words. So I may get one that's incorrect because it should have been correct, but it thought it should be 35 when I said jumps rather than jumped. Let's take a look and see what we got. Okay, starting on, say, llama 2 again. So llama 2 got, the word lengths 3 and 5 and 6. So here we're off. We're already off by one. Now we're off by another one because Fox is wrong. Now we're off by a lot. And in fact, I think it got the lengths of more of the words wrong than right. And then I'm not even sure it summed them up right. So yeah, llama 2, yep, not at all. How about codellama? Do any better? Yeah, one-liner. The sum of the lengths of the words in the sentence, "the quick brown fox jumped over the lazy dog," is 46, which is, again, wrong, but no underlying data or anything. Now, Phi is a model from Microsoft, and that one actually worked on the last one too, so I didn't really emphasize it. But Phi has this tendency to go off on tangents and just do whatever. So here is Phi. So we need to add up the lengths of each word, split the sentence into a list of words using the space characters of delimiter. That's right. Use a loop or a built-in function, iterate over it, add up all the lengths. The result will be the sum of the lengths. It all looks good. So now it wrote Python. There's the sentence. There's a split method, has a variable for the sum, and then a loop for word in words, and then it's going to plus equal the length of each word. And it got 35, and it actually should be 36, but unfortunately, I can't tell which one is wrong. 35 is wrong. Remember, it should have been 36, but I don't know why. But again, it couldn't stop itself. It kept going. Imagine you're a network security specialist who uses artificial intelligence to monitor network traffic. You have an AI system that can calculate the average length of sentences it encounters and compare them with known averages to detect unusual activity, such as when someone tries to disguise their communications by changing the sentence structure. So we go into this weird scenario and come up with the mean of the data set is and a standard deviation. So is it unusual? Okay. We use proof by contradiction, proof by transitivity, and direct proof. And we're going on and on. I mean, holy mackerel. And the answer is based on our analysis, the first sentence of the paragraph would not be considered unusual. Why is it even doing this? I have no idea what triggered all that, but there you go. We got to save tinyllama. That's going to be the fun one. How about wizard math? That one did well before. So we count the lengths of each word. So, all right, we're off already. So the has four letters. Interestingly enough, of course, the appears twice, even though the Unicode values would be slightly different because here we have a capital T and here we have a lowercase one. But it got them wrong both times. So either four letters or two letters, but it's wrong each time. Those are right, that's wrong. That's right, that's right. And what do we get? It adds them all up and gets, well, the actual right answer, but for the completely wrong reason. So what are you going to do? I mean, what a mess. And we got 36, but somehow the addition is messed up because, or maybe all the errors were off in compensating ways. But yeah, that's not good. Okay, what about that star coder disaster? So star coder problem 5, what is the length? Yeah, okay, so it said problem 6, same question. Problem 7, same question. And then wrote the beginnings of a Python function to get the lengths and stopped. Okay, how about the 7 billion parameter model? Did that do better? Couldn't load it, gave up. All right, I mean, I probably have to just try again on that one. Mixtral is the Mistral version that uses the mixture of experts approach, and that tends to do really well, with especially with complicated problems. How did it do here? Well, that's the right number of letters. Those are right, that's right, that's right. That's right, that's right, that's right. They're all right. So I got the right numbers of letters and somehow managed to add them wrong. I mean, look at this. 5 and 5 is 10. 6 and 4 is 10. 3, 3 and 3 is, so now we're up to 29. And 7 would be 36. And it got 39. So the place it failed was in adding the numbers. Wow, I would not have expected that. At least I didn't ask it to take the square root. Okay, so that's Mixtral. How about Neural Chat? Neural Chat says split the sentence into an array of words, iterate through the array, print or return the final sum. Here's our Python implementation. And that looks pretty reasonable, except that it got the wrong answer. So I don't know what part of that failed because it didn't give me enough detail to let me know where it went wrong. But yeah, I mean, yes, but no. Okay, vicuna. The sum of the lengths of the words in the sentence is 10. No, it's not 10. I promise you, I don't know. I mean, I may have off by one errors. I used to think that was my middle name, but it's not 10. How about the gemma models? The small one just said, yeah, it's 13. Just believe me, because no extra steps. And the bigger one says 44. Again, no extra work. It did echo the sentence again, but said, yeah, there's 44 letters in there. Yeah, okay. I guess I should have said to show its work a little bit more. Orca-mini, that one's always a bit of a struggle. And you know what's notable about this one? I took a glance at this one ahead of time. Every single word count is wrong. The number of letters is wrong on the, quick, brown, fox, jumped, over, lazy, and dog. It got every single one wrong, and it missed the second the, right? I mean, the, quick, brown, fox, jumped, over, the, lazy, dog. And then these numbers that it came up with, it claimed to add, of course, again, missing one. Doesn't look like there's enough there. It only added 6 of them for some reason. And then I don't think that addition is correct either. So, wow. I mean, there's 10 and 8 and 7 is 15 and 5 is 20. That should be 30. And wow, I got nothing. Okay, finally, the one I've been saving just to see what it was going to do. Poor little tiny llama. And yeah, 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 is 9. It did not disappoint. Yep, that's exactly it. The quick brown fox jumped over. The lazy dog is equal to 9. It looks like it took the bullet numbers 1, 2, 3, and 4 and added them incorrectly. That should be 10, right? 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yeah. Okay. There's your stupid AI tricks. So what have we learned? What did this little exercise demonstrate? Do not trust large language models to do basic, simple math without some tool support. Now, the bigger commercial models, they've got a lot of this worked out, at least the simple sorts of tests I was giving it. The larger models, yeah, all right, they're doing fine. But if you're trying to stay on a free tier because you don't want to pay for these things, you better have some error checking ready to go. You better be able to validate whatever answers you're getting back, because who knows what you're actually going to see. So, okay, I mean, that tool support makes all the difference in the world. I do suggest that if you have the opportunity, please watch the follow-up video that shows how you can use that tool support with LangChain for J to get the right answers, especially in cases like this. Thank you very much, and I'll see you on the next episode of Tales from the Jar Side.
Hey there, devs, it's time to tune in to Tales from the Jar, so let's begin. Java, come in and spring, oh my. Groovy, Gradle, don't be shy. Tales from the Jar Side, oh yeah. Crack open the code, let's take a ride. From design patterns to the latest trends, your weekly tech toast that never ends.